Reggae Guitar Lesson for Bitch by Meredith Brooks. It's just for the guitar solo, and so I'm just going to go quickly through that. So the guitar solo, the first part of it, well, most of it actually centers around just using two strings. So basically, if you go up to the 10th fret on the B string, which is there, and you're pushing down on that string as well as the open E, so you're getting this kind of noise. So I'll just turn that down a bit. So the first part of it, you're sliding up to the from the 10th fret to the 12th fret, so like this. So up to the 12th and back to the 10th. So it's like a downstroke, then slide up. So up, down. So that's the first part of it. And it's almost a similar sort of scenario for the next part, but you move down to the 5th fret and slide up to the 7th. So I'll go from the start. And again, same two strings with the open E, just the bottom, you're always using that open E, that's the common thread in that phrase. So just go from the start again. So fifth up the 7th, and then the 7th back to the 5th. So after that phrase, you go back up to the 7th. So I'm just going to go from the start again. So that third phrase is from the 7th down to the 5th down to the 3rd. So let's just go through the whole thing again. So that's the first part of that solo. And then it goes back to the beginning again, and it's almost an identical phrase that you're going to next. So you're going 10th to the 12th, so the next part is again to the 10th to the 12th, 5th to the 7th, and instead of going to the 3rd, it's going to cut in, and on the G string on the 11th fret, so that phrase is 11th fret on the G string, 10th fret on the B string, so so 11, 10, back to 11, and then to the 12th fret on the B string, and bend that right up. So after that bend, you go back to the 10th. Fret on the B string, so after that bend you go into the 10th on the B, and then back to the 11th fret on the G, so bend, 10 on the B, 11 on the G, and back to the 10th fret on the B. Solo what we've got so far. So after that part we come to the kind of last phrase in the solo. So it's the E string on the 5th fret, on the B string on the 7th fret, so 5 and 7, and then bar the bottom two strings on the 5th fret, so you've got that first, so 5th and the 7th, then bar the 5th, and then on the G string on the 6th fret, 6, and then the 4th fret on the G string, and then the 7th fret on the D string, and then the 4th fret. And that's it. So I'll just go quickly over that part again. 5th and 7th, the 5th, and then 6th fret on the G, 4th fret on the G, 7 on the D, 4 on the D, and then back to the 7th fret on the D, which is an A note. Okay, hopefully that's been of some help to you. See you again next time. Bye.